Hi, welcome to Rise with Chuck. Tucked away in the woods in Crystal Lake, Illinois is the Small Wonders Microcar Museum. Let's talk to the owner, Ken Weger.
Welcome to Small Wonders Microcar Museum here in Crystal Lake, Illinois. Our goal is to restore and salvage and restore micro and mini cars. Micro and mini cars started at the turn of the century when people really got tired of getting wet riding bicycles. A lot of them are just glorified scooters. We have cars that range from all ages from 1920 to current, and our cars come from all over the world. We're gonna walk through and see a few of our cars today and go through probably six or seven of them and just give you a little detail on what they are. So typically the cars run, micros are considered from 500 cc's down, and some of our smaller cars go down as low as 49 cc's for the engine. Some of the bigger cars are 1600 cc's, up to the AMFA car and MG Midgets and MGAs. So the first car we're gonna look at today is a 1920 Briggs and Stratton Flyer. This was built and started in 1914 by an engineer in England and brought over by A.O. Smith in 1917. They bought the patent rights. The car is a 1920 model. They built them till 1923. They've also branched off, and this is how Briggs and Stratton got started building engines. Up until then, they had been building accessory hardware for the automotive industry after trying to get into the automotive industry once with one car in the early 20s. This car has a single cylinder. It has a fifth wheel and simply a clutch lever to let the wheel down, and it scoots off. At the time this was built in 1920, the cost was double that of a Model T Ford. So this was more of a novelty car for people on the East Coast and on the shore. Most of the cars that actually ended up out in there. In the Midwest and in the Chicagoland area, for some reason, we have quite a few here. This was restored by Kurt Larson, who was the curator and vice president of manufacturing, and then became the president of Briggs and Stratton Canada. And this was restored for his own personal collection, and we were lucky enough to get it in our collection about 8 years ago. She's really a beautiful automobile and drives, and I've actually driven the car, and now we have it up on the podium so you can really see it. Briggs and Stratton also built some other things. They came up with an adaption to put their small motors on a bicycle. They actually had a small scooter, and they actually built an engine for Maytag for their washing machines out in the rural areas of the Appalachians, which we're still looking for. So, the next car we're going to look at is one of the prizes of our collection. This is a 1950 Reyonnah. Reyonnah was built by an engineer in France whose name was Hanover. He decided that he was going to apply for the government of France for some money to tool up and build in production. This is the car. He started off with 17 automobiles and only six were completed. This is serial number four. Serial number one is still owned by the family in France. Its novelty is it's very narrow. It's made that way intentionally, and the wheels fold up. You see it today, it's in the up position. You literally lift the bumper up and the wheels fold underneath the car and allows the car to be pushed through a doorway and put and stored inside or in a gate going to your backyard. Obviously, in France, parking is really at a premium, so this allowed the owner to put it inside his house, and when he was ready to go to work, push it outside, roll it, and the wheels would unfold, and away you went. Since this car has been acquired by us several years ago, another one popped up last year. It was finished with parts that were found, but only seven of them now have been completed of the original 17. We don't think any more are going to come out. So it's very, very, very rare, and we're very pleased to have it in our collection. It's one of our key cars in our collection.